I'll just start timing you when you're ready to go, and I think I'll give you I'll say 1 minute remaining, and stop you at 10 minutes, and then they'll go into their questions for 10 minutes. So whenever you're ready.
All right, we're ready. Good morning, and on behalf of Furman University, I just want to thank you for allowing us to present to you this morning. My name is Sarah Budd, this is Aaron Towery, Matthew Thomas, and Will Chesson. Our recommendation is to sell Rock 10. We believe that it's overvalued. Our price target is $63.87, and we base this decision off of our analysis of the competitive environment, the financial statements, our valuation, and the investment risks.
The first thing I'm going to go into here is a Porter's Five Force analysis. The first part I'm going to do is the competitive rivalry. The industry they're in is has a standard product, not much quality differentiation. So the main thing is their selling point is going to be cost and their ability to sell the product. With their recent acquisition of SmartBit, they acquired a lot of management that they don't necessarily like, wasn't the original part, which they had a very good original management team. And this new team isn't quite as good, so I think that's going to hurt their competitive level. Second part I'm going to go into is supplier power. In this industry, the suppliers like don't have much control at all. Because they're selling the product, they're going to have to base it at a certain price. And they're just not going to be able to sell it well, especially with Rock 10 not being able to produce the price and having to raise costs due to this market acquisition. Third thing is the buyer power. The buyers have control in this market because they are going to switch between suppliers based off price. There's no real quality or brand like thing that they're going to go for, and they're not going to stay with a brand just because of a brand. The fourth thing I'm going to go into is the product and technology development. With there are a lot of substitutes in this industry as well, such as plastic. Other things that do offer higher quality or lower quality, but they are cheaper, more expensive, and it just depends what Rock 10 is going to be able to sell their product at. And I do not believe they're going to be able to sell their product at currently at as low cost as this is going to be at a competitive level. The fifth thing is threat of entry, and there's not really going to be much threat of entry into this market because of the large capital expenditures and the low profit margin. So, but the main thing is going to be the market, and that means Rock 10 is going to have to stay in there no matter what. Overall, I'm feeling they're overvalued, and they're going to start falling off soon.
When we looked at the financials, we did a ratio analysis going back 5 years. We looked at liquidity, asset management, debt management, and profitability. In the category of liquidity, they're very liquidly compared to their competitors. And with their recent acquisition and high debt, that's concerning to us. Asset management, they manage their inventory really well. They turn it over quickly, but their fixed assets are not efficient. They have a really high fixed asset turnover, a lot higher than their industry competitors. And a lot of that has to do with their recent acquisition of SmartBit. But we expected that to go down after a two-year period post-acquisition. Debt management, their debt ratios are still high. We wanted to see them go down after a couple of years post-acquisitions, but they've remained the same. And the times interest earned, it went up after the acquisition, and it went down this past year, which we found concerning because we wanted to see that go up, showing that they have better control over their interest costs, especially with their high debt. And profitability, return on assets and return on equity both took a hit in 2010 after the acquisition, and they stayed low. They haven't gone back up to where they have been before. And although their revenues have increased and their bottom line has increased, their margins have decreased significantly, which is our biggest concern with their financial statements, which means they're not controlling costs. Their cost of goods sold as a percentage of sales are high. Their SG&A costs are high. And because of that, we don't recommend buying the stock.
to value Rock 10, we used both a price-to-earnings ratio in order to compare Rock 10 to its competitors and to the market at large. And when we used this ratio, we found that Rock 10 was considerably overvalued in relation to many of its performers and as to the S&P 500 as well. And in addition to that, we also found that Rock 10 and the overall industry as a whole was generally underperforming in comparison to the S&P and the overall stock market. And in order to analyze the fundamentals of the company, basically we used a discounted cash flow model, which we paid attention to the fact that the Affordable Health Care Act is coming into play now, and over the next 2 to 3 years, we feel that will affect Rock 10's cash flow due to its employees. And we also feel that their overwhelming pension debt is starting to grow large, considering they are overfunded with their own pension, and in addition to their recent acquisition of Smurfit Stones, having to absorb all of those pensions to fund, which we feel makes them quite overvalued.
The Smurfit Stone acquisition was a transformational merger because it resulted in Rock 10 going from a minor player in the corrugated packaging industry to becoming the second largest producer. Rock 10 also faces the risk of fully integrating the Smurfit Stone assets in order to maximize the benefits of marginal expansion. Rock 10 has a history of successful integrations with the deleveraging of Southern Container and Gulf Stage, which allowed them to produce the expected synergies that Rock 10 Rock 10 proposes a problem, though, because it's a larger and higher cost network. This integration has been limited by a large amount of leverage that has resulted in margins lagging and has caused underinvestment in its mill operations, which has made it more difficult to integrate. Worse than expected results in integration have caused Rock 10 to replace former Smurfit corrugated packaging managers and recycling managers with Rock 10 managers. This is a problem because it could result in the new managers not being familiar with the industry, causing them to kind of lag with operations. Rock 10 has a large amount of pension debt with the acquisition of Smurfit Stone, which has caused the pension plans of Rock 10 to be underfunded by over $1.4 billion. This means that Rock 10 must make large cash contributions to these plans, which may result in a misallocation of capital that may be needed to address other issues involved with the integration of Smurfit Stone. The current estimates for pension contributions in 2014 and 2016 range from $249 million to $372 million. These cash contributions will have a significant impact on future cash flows and could be used for expenditures and business operations. The acquisition also helped raise the goodwill on Rock 10's balance sheet to over 17% of total assets. Most of Rock 10's debt doesn't mature until late 2018 or late 2021, meaning that there is time for the company to manage it appropriately, although it could be difficult to pay off with a significant economic fluctuation such as a recession.
So in conclusion, we recommend selling Rock 10 stock. We think that it's going to start decreasing in the next 12 months.
Within the 9 minutes.
We'll pause for just a bit for the judges to collect their thoughts, and then we'll have a little Q&A after that.
Thank you.
I have a question. Could you all kind of go through and clarify exactly what's happening to management post-merger and what your concerns are there?
There are some difficulties with, they really weren't producing the type of synergies that they were expecting.
Okay.
That
I'm sorry, who is they?
Rock 10, excuse me.
So Rock 10's previous management?
Right.
Okay.
They, with their previous acquisitions of Gulf State, they had been able to produce their expected synergies very efficiently, and with the purchase of Smurfit Stone, because it's been so much larger, they've kind of lagged a little bit in producing those synergies. So because of this lag, they decided to replace some of the current managers in their Smurfit mill, like factories and stuff, with new Rock 10 managers that may be able to produce better synergies and make the factories more efficient.
I apologize because we're not supposed to ask multiple point questions, but I'm really having a hard time understanding this. Who is the new management? Where did they come from? Were they Smurfit managers?
They're existing Rock 10 managers.
They were Rock 10. Okay.
They just like relocated them effectively.
Okay.
Did how much of the Smurfit management remains?
I didn't get an exact percentage of.
Forget the percentage, but just like. Of the top few people, are there any that remain either in advisory roles or as COOs or anything like that? I mean,
there are a few that do remain, okay. But they only replace the ones that are, I guess.
But possible. Really, what you're saying is that the synergies that were projected by Rock 10, at least when they made the acquisition, have not occurred.
Right.
And that's a lot of the. A lot of the ding in valuation, is that right?
Yes, sir.
I mean, just for instance, my question is kind of really open-ended about, quite honestly, your valuation is a lot lower than the other few that I've read, and I'm just sort of trying to get an idea of why that is. But I guess that's one of them. You've incorporated the fact that synergies will not happen, maybe ever.
Can you go back to the slide where you had the presentation? I just want to take one more look at it.
No, let me see.
Okay, go forward.
Yeah.
Right there.
And did you all take into account possible growth, you know, when you're looking at these valuations, for example, PEG ratio or something like that, or price to earnings over growth, or
we did not.
Okay.
Did you all? Just correct me. This isn't. Doesn't matter one way or the other, but it seems that in your talking points, I think you mentioned doing a discounted cash flow. Is that correct?
Mm-hmm.
Was that part of your valuation? I didn't actually see a slide on what valuation you got for the discounted cash flow.
The 6387 through the discounted cash flow.
Oh, that's okay.
But was there a slide on that or any sort
there
of detail on that?
Projected cash flow growth.
Okay.
Not that.
And is that cash flow the same as earnings?
That's free cash flow.
That's free cash flow?
Mm-hmm.
And you'd say that's probably more aggressive, if you could use that word, than earnings?
Mm-hmm.
And what, how did y'all calculate your cost of capital?
We used the cap in.
Now, is a lot of the, I mean, that's an interesting one, actually. sure if it actually results in a higher or lower number. I mean, the debt that was required that's on the balance sheet of Rock 10 now, a lot of it is maybe temporary, mm-hmm. or not so temporary, based on the spare bit acquisition. Mm-hmm. Is some of that supposed to go away? I mean, they're at a higher debt level, debt to equity, than they usually are.
Right.
Is that, do you think, is that going to stay that way? Or do you think they can actually get rid of some of that debt at some point, maybe by restructuring their balance sheet or just through cash flow?
I think it's once they increase the profitability of Smurfit, it might go through, but I don't see that happening as the economy is not doing great. It's not going to be able to raise profitability.
I think one of the things is, looking at your discussion about your use of discounted cash flow, you say that after 5 years, you basically just assume GDP growth, mm-hmm. which is conservative.
Yeah.
And I'm not sure if that's any more conservative or actually less than the others, but anyway, that's what it is.
Is that? That's in their report.
Yeah.
Which we're not conservative.
I know.
Okay. I missed that one. All right.
Now we're just trying to, like, we're grading their poise to answer the questions, not really what the answers are. All right, well, thank you.
All right, thanks.